Let us see organic compounds containing nitrogen. In that, first amines. Amines are derivatives of ammonia, in which one or more than one hydrogen atoms of ammonia replaced by corresponding number of alkyl or aryl groups. Suppose if one hydrogen atom is replaced by one alkyl group called as primary amines, represented by RNH2. The functional group in this is NH2, called as amino group. If two hydrogen atoms of ammonia replaced by two alkyl group or aryl groups, then it is called as secondary amine. Functional group is NH, called as imino group. If all these three hydrogen atoms of ammonia are replaced by three alkyl or aryl groups, then it is called as tertiary amine. The functional group is tertiary nitrogen atom. Okay. Now here, in case of secondary amine, these both alkyl or aryl groups may be same or different. If both are same, called as simple or symmetrical amine. And if they are different, called as mixed or unsymmetrical amine. Same thing here. If all are same, called as simple or symmetrical. If one or two are different, called as mixed or unsymmetrical amine. Now one thing remember here. Here the concept of primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine is totally different from primary, secondary, tertiary, alkyl halide, alcohol and nitro compounds. Listen, here in case of primary amine, NH2 group is attached to one alkyl group. That alkyl group may be isobutyl, may be sacbutyl, may be tert-butyl, may be methyl, any alkyl group here. Okay, that is a primary amine. That is, NH2 group is attached to one alkyl group. But in this case, here halogen or OH or NO2 group attached to primary carbon, then they are called as primary alkyl halide, alcohol or nitro compound. In case of secondary, here NH group is present and that is attached to two alkyl group. Okay. Two alkyl group, that any two alkyl group. Okay, but in case of this, here halogen, OH or NH2, that is these functional groups are attached to secondary carbon, then they are called as secondary compounds. Okay, in case of tertiary amine, here nitrogen atom is attached to three alkyl groups, any three alkyl groups, called as tertiary amine. And here halogen, OH or this NO2 functional group is attached to tertiary carbon, then they are called as tertiary. Remember, simple way, if NH2 is there, primary amine. NH is there, secondary amine. N is there, then tertiary amine. Okay, so about amines. Primary, secondary, tertiary amines are functional isomers of each other. That is, they are differ in their functional group. What is different? That name is given to isomerism. Functional group is different. They are functional isomerism. Now next part, consider nitroalkanes and alkyl nitrite. Now nitroalkane and alkyl nitrite, in that see here RNO, this one. In case of this nitro group, here actually two centers of attachment are there. That is, this nitro group can attach to this alkyl group either through this nitrogen or through this oxygen. See here, if here attach to this O and then NO. That is, two centers of attachment are there. One is N and one is O. If it is attached through the N, then these are called as nitroalkane. Nitroalkane. And if it is attached through the oxygen, called as alkyl nitrite. Such a groups, those having two centers of attachment, called as ambident group. Called as ambident group. Now, here, this nitroalkane and alkyl nitrite, these two are again functional isomers of each other. One thing, this may be a derivative of nitrous acid. Yes, nitrous acid is HNO2. Here H is replaced by R. That is alkyl nitrite. Okay, next consider now nitriles and isonitriles. Nitriles, also called as cyanide. And here again, this is an ambident group. Here, two centers of attachment. Here, if it is attached through carbon, then these are called as alkyl cyanides or called as nitriles. And if it is attached through nitrogen, then it is called as alkyl isonitrile or alkyl isocyanide or called as carbyl amine. See here, these are isonitriles, isocyanides or carbyl amines if it is attached through nitrogen, and these are called as cyanides or nitriles. These are also functional isomers of one another. That is, nitriles and isonitriles are functional isomers. That is, these are functional isomers, these are functional isomers, and these are functional isomers. Now, let us see nomenclature of these compounds containing nitrogen one by one. First, amines, then nitroalkanes, then alkyl nitrites, then nitriles, and then isonitriles. Besides this, also other organic compounds are there containing nitrogen. Diazonium salts, consider that part in nomenclature of aromatic compounds. Other aliphatic compounds are also there, oxime, hydrazone, phenylhydrazone, etc. Okay. Let us see nomenclature of primary amines. General formula is CnH2n+3n. And suffix is amine. Here one thing remember that for all primary amine, secondary amine and tertiary amine, they have same general formula and same suffix for IUPAC system. Okay. Next, they are represented as RNH2. Here R is alkyl group or aryl. We are considering today aliphatic amine, therefore R is alkyl group. Functional group is NH2. Now, consider examples. Here R, I have written alkyl group. You have studied this part in earlier session. Methyl, ethyl, N-propyl, isopropyl, N-butyl, isobutyl, sec-butyl and tert-butyl. This R part. Now join NH2, that is a homologous series of primary amine is formed. This is the first member, second member, third member, like this. These are the homologs of primary amine. Now their common names. Now, common names, same as discussed in earlier session. First, write the name of the R and then write the family name, that is amine for this NH2. That is name of the R and then name of this NH2. It is a amine. Common name for amines is a single word name or one word name. Therefore, this is a methyl amine. Like this, methyl amine, ethyl amine. Name of this R, N-propyl join amine. Like this, join amine. That is, in general, the common name for amine is alkyl amine. Write the name of the alkyl group and then join the word amine. Remember only this word, you can write the common name of any primary amine. Now consider IUPAC name. As usual, is continuous carbon, word root, and then join the suffix. That is methane, one carbon, therefore methane, add suffix amine. Suffix is used in IUPAC name. Yes, ethane amine, two carbon, therefore ethane amine. Next, three carbon atoms here, therefore propane amine. See here, three carbon atoms start numbering from this. Word root is propane amine. There is no any prefix. Next, see here again same. 1, 2, 3. Propane amino group is present on carbon number 2. Therefore, propane, then join the suffix 2-amine. Propane 2-amine. E is dropped because here A. Now this is continuous 4. Therefore, butane drop E by amine. You studied in the earlier session. Now see here, continuous carbon atoms are 3. Numbering start from this carbon because functional group is here. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, propane. This is the first rule. Then, prefix for substituent. 2-methyl. And then, functional group is amine. That is, 2-methyl propane. 1-amine. Or, you may write or may not be write. Written, that is amine. 2-methylpropanamine. Then next, this one is continuous 4 carbon. Start numbering from this side. Therefore, 1, 2, 3, 4. 2-amine. Butane. Butane. Continuous carbon. Therefore, 4. 2-amine. This is the suffix. Suffix the number, suffix chati. Next year, continuous carbon 3, 1, 2, 3, or you may count 1, 2, 3 includes the functional group. Therefore, 1, 2, and this one is 3. Continuous 3, therefore, word root is propane, 2-methyl propane, 2-amine. That is 2-methyl propane. 2-amine. The IUPAC name of tert-butylamine. Here, the IUPAC name general as alkane amine. That is, first write the continuous carbon atom, word root alkane, replace E by amine. Suffix amine. Here, one thing remember that isobutylamine, sec-butylamine, or tert-butylamine. Or R and H2 all are primary amine. Tert-butylamine is a primary amine. Okay, so are the primary amines. Let us see some more examples of primary amines. Now, this one, vinyl group. We studied this in earlier session. Vinyl amine. It is vinyl amine. Now next, this group, allyl, you know that, allyl amine, now see here, this group, this one, this is a ethylene, two times amine, that is diamine. Therefore, ethylene diamine. This compound is used in the preparation of coordination compound. It is required in topic coordination compound. Okay, next. Now consider this one. This is CH2 group. You know, this is a methyl group. Then this one is methylene group. This is called as methylene group. Six times methylene, that is hexamethylene diamine. Hexamethylene diamine. It is used in the preparation of nylon 6,6 polymer. Okay, next, this one, cyclopentylamine. Cyclopentylamine. Six, therefore, cyclohexylamine. Next, I have taken here compound containing two functional group, that is NH2 and COH. Amino acid. This is the amino acid. The common name is glycine. It is required in topic biomolecules, proteins. Next, now consider their IUPAC name. Now, IUPAC name, see here, continuous carbon 2, start numbering from this side, because this is a principal function group, seniority table. Okay, therefore, ethinamine. Both are present on carbon number 1, therefore it is not necessary to mention that. Or you may write ethinamine. Next, start numbering from this side. S 1, 2, 3. 2 in. Prop-2-in-amine. Prop-2-in-amine. Amine is present on carbon number 1. You may write prop-2-in-1-amine. Or simply in-amine. Okay. Next. Now this one. Continuous 2 carbon atoms here. Therefore, ethane 1,2-diamine. Ethane 2 carbon, therefore ethane, then 1,2-diamine. Here it starts with D, therefore not replace E. Here 6 carbon, therefore hexane 1, and on carbon number 6 amine, therefore hexane 1,6-diamine. Next, this is a cyclopentane-amine. Cyclopentane. Now, replace E by amine. Next, cyclohexane. Replace E by amine. Cyclohexane. Amine. Now, see this two functional group. You know the seniority table. In seniority table, it is at the highest place. Therefore, it is the principal group. It gets the lowest possible number. Therefore, 1, 2. Now, it is a substituent. Therefore, use its prefix as a amino. 2-amino. Then, continuous 2 carbon. Therefore, ethane. Prefix is 2-amino. And oic acid. That is 2-amino ethane E replaced by suffix oic acid. This is a ethanoic acid on which 2-amino ethanoic acid. This is the IUPAC name of this compound. Let us see now nomenclature of secondary amines. General formula is same as that of primary amine. Representation R2NH. These are R is alkyl groups or aryl groups. Now consider only here alkyl groups. These two are, that is two alkyl groups may be same, then simple or symmetrical amines. If both are different, then called as mixed or unsymmetrical amines. Functional group is NH and suffix is same to that of primary amine, it is an amine. Let us see one example. Is NH is there, then join any two similar alkyl groups, simple methyl, then next consider join the both ethyl groups. Now consider their common names. Common names are similar to that of, you studied the ketones or ethers. Here, name of these alkyl groups and ether. Name of these two alkyl groups and ketone. Dialkyl ether, dialkyl ketone. Same here. The name of these two alkyl group and then write amine. That is dimethyl amine. Here either side alkyl groups are present. Here diethyl amine. Next, that is, it is same to that of, or generally can write dialkyl amine. Next, consider now some examples of mixed or unsymmetrical amines. Suppose CH3 NH and join ethyl group. Take one more example. You may join any two different alkyl groups. Suppose ethyl and N-propyl. You may write methyl and N-propyl like this. Here, now write the name of this compound, common name. Here ethyl and here methyl. Arrange alphabetically. That is ethyl methyl amine. Now here ethyl N-propyl amine. Ethyl N-propyl amine. That is, in general, for mixed secondary amine, write the name of the alkyl, another alkyl amine. Alkyl, alkyl amine. Like this. Okay. Now, consider their IUPAC name. Now, IUPAC name, as usual, you studied in earlier session, continuous carbon only one. Here also one. Select the longest chain side for the parent name. Now here only one, therefore methyl, then suffix is amine. This is the substituent present on nitrogen. Therefore first N-methyl, continuous carbon one, therefore methane, join suffix amine. Next, now here both sides are same, therefore N-ethyl is a substituent now. It's a continuous carbon, only two. Therefore, ethane. Suffix is amine and prefix is N-ethyl. N-ethyl ethanamine. That is, in general, N-alkyl alkanamine. Once you know this word, you can write the name of any secondary amine. Okay. Now consider the IUPAC name of these two compounds. Here continuous carbon, this side is more, therefore consider it is for word root ethane. Then this is a parent name. This is now substituent. N-ethyl ethanamine. N-ethyl ethanamine. Now here continuous three carbon atoms here, therefore this is select for the word root, and now this is substituent N-ethyl propanamine. N-ethyl propanamine. right? Propane replace E by amine. That is, in general, it is N-alkyl alkanamine. Same. Only remember the smaller side, that is a side containing less number of carbon atom is selected for the prefix, that is considered as a substituent. Okay, these are the secondary amines. Let us see nomenclature for tertiary amine. General formula same, suffix is same as that of primary and secondary. Representation is R3N. These, all these groups may be same or different. If all are same, simple or symmetrical. If different, mixed or unsymmetrical. Functional group is tertiary nitrogen atom. Okay. Now consider some examples of simple amines. All are same. Suppose 3 CH3 groups present on nitrogen. That is trimethyl amine. You may write this like this, CH3, N, CH3, CH3. That is, okay. Now, consider the common name of this. Name of the alkyl groups, trimethyl amine. Therefore, trimethyl amine. Consider another example, C2H5, 3 times N, that is, you may write its structure as a CH3, CH2N, CH3, CH2N, like this, CH3, CH2, N, CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. Triethyl amine, the name is triethyl amine. That is, in general, for tertiary simple amine, trialkyl amine. Okay. Now, consider some examples of mixed amine. Before that, let us see their IUPAC name. IUPAC name, now see here. Select one of the alkyl group for a root word. That is, base name, word root. Which is longest one? Now here all are same, therefore consider any one, therefore methane. And now these two are the substituents. Therefore N-methyl, N-methyl, that is N-N-dimethyl methane, and then suffix is amine, methanamine. This is a word root, S parent name, that is one carbon, therefore methane. Then prefixes are, these are the substituents. 2-methyl, that is dimethyl, present on N-N, prefix. And then join the suffix amine. Here same, N-N-diethyl, ethanamine. N-N-diethyl, ethanamine. Therefore, general IUPAC name is N-N dialkyl. Remember only this one. You can write the IUPAC name of any tertiary amine. N-N dialkyl alkanamine. That is, suffix is amine. Okay. Now consider mixed tertiary amines. Just consider one example, CH3 twice N, then CH2, CH3. Okay, that is 2-methyl groups and 1-ethyl group. Consider first some examples. Now consider opposite, 2-ethyl groups and 1-methyl group. Then consider one more example. Here, methyl, then ethyl, C2H5, and then N-propyl. Consider one more example. Here, methyl, then ethyl, And then isopropylene is isopropylene. That is, all these three groups are different. Here, two groups are same, one group is different. All are mixed tertiary amines. Now consider their common name first. See here, this ethyl and these are dimethyl. Therefore, ethyl first alphabetically, then dimethyl amine. Now here, diethyl methyl amine. Diethyl methyl amine. Here alphabetically E and then M. Don't consider the di, tri, secondary, tertiary. That words are not considered in alphabetical order. Okay. Here E and then M. Okay. Diethyl methyl amine. Next. Now here methyl, ethyl and N-propyl. Therefore first one is ethyl, then methyl, then N-propyl. That is, ethyl methyl N-propyl amine. Then next here, ethyl, then methyl and then isopropyl. M-N-O-P. Therefore, ethyl, methyl and isopropyl. That is, ethyl, methyl, isopropyl amine. Write the name of the alkyl groups. Three may be different or two may be different, and then write amine. That is alkyl groups here, and then write for amine. Okay, next. Now IUPAC name. Now IUPAC name, first select one of the alkyl group which is longest one for the word rule. Now this one. Therefore, ethane. Okay, first rule. Then these are the prefixes. That is N-N dimethyl. N-N dimethyl ethanamine. Ethanamine. Now see here. Here two chains are there with the same length. One is selected for the word root and the remaining one is considered as a substituent. Therefore, now the substituents are one ethyl and one methyl. Therefore, N-ethyl, N-methyl, ethanamine. Yes, N-ethyl, then N-methyl, ethanamine. Now see here, continuous this one, three carbon atoms, therefore this is the word root, parent name is this one, propane, and these are the substituents, N-ethyl, N-methyl, propanamine, N-ethyl, N-methyl, propanamine. Now consider this. More number of carbon, therefore this is the parent name. This is numbered from one of the end, therefore 1, 2 and 3. This is the selected chain. Therefore, parent name is propane. Base name is propane. Root word is propane. Now, see here, prefixes. Methyl and ethyl. That is, N-ethyl, N-methyl, N-ethyl, then N-methyl, propane. That is our prefix second rule. And the last rule, suffix is amine, which is present on carbon number 2 of the main chain, parent chain, selected chain. Therefore, propane 2-amine. That is, here name is same N-N-dialkyl alkanamine, or here, sorry, N alkyl, then N alkyl alkanamine, alkanamine. These are the tertiary amines. Let us consider now next family, nitroalkane. They are represented as RNO2. R may be alkyl or aryl group. Its structure, functional group is NO2 and its prefix is used as a nitro. If prefix is there, it is joined to further parent name, word root, therefore dash is here. But if suffix is there, all, own, then dash is here because it is joined to word root here only. Therefore, suffix first dash, if prefix is there, then after dash is there. Okay, dash is here. Now, I already told in first session that ROR, alkyl, alkoxy, nitro, nitroso, and halo, they have only prefixes. There is no suffix for these functional group and substituent. Only prefix is nitro. And one more thing, for nitroalkane, there is no common name for nitroalkanes. Now, consider examples. You know that alkyl group, that is R, alkyl groups are there. Now, join only NO2, yes, NO2, then RNO2 is formed. Different alkyl groups are there. Now, consider their IUPAC name. Yes, as usual, this is a prefix, continuous carbon 1, therefore methane, nitromethane, because nitro is a prefix, nitromethane, nitroethane, nitroethane, nitropropane, nitro. Propane. Next, now here continuous carbon chain 1, 2, 3. On carbon number 2, nitro group is present. Therefore, 2-nitropropane. 2-nitropropane. Next, nitrobutane. Continuous 4 carbon atoms. Therefore, nitrobutane. Now see here, start numbering from this side. 2, 3, therefore 2-methyl-1-nitropropane, 2-methyl-1-nitropropane, then this is 2-nitrobutane, 1, 2, 3, 4, therefore 2-nitrobutane. Now continuous 3 carbon only, therefore 1, 2, 3. This is substituent. This is substituent. Therefore, first methyl and then nitro alphabetically. Therefore, 2-methyl, 2-nitro propane. No common name for these compounds. Therefore, in general, remember only nitroalkane. Remember this word, then you can write the IUPAC name of any compound. Now consider alkyl nitrite. Now actually, this NO2 group, it has two centers of linkage. Here, two centers of linkage, it is attached through nitrogen here. And here it is attached through oxygen. Such a groups are called as ambident group. Ambident group. Now consider the nomenclature of this alkyl nitrite. It has also no common name. Now these alkyl nitrites are considered as a derivative of nitrous acid. This is a nitrous acid, HNO2. HNO2. This H is replaced by this R. That is alkyl derivative of nitrous acid. Therefore, we may call as esters of alkyl, that is see here, esters of nitrous acid, because you know the esters, that is R-O-C-O-dash, the esters, okay, you studied the nomenclature of this as a alkyl alkanoate. Alkyl, that is first write the name of the alkyl group which is joined to oxygen, therefore alkyl alkanoate. Same here, alkyl nitrite, the name is alkyl nitrite. Consider one example is here methyl ON, that is this is a nitrite and this is a methyl, therefore methyl nitrite, just like that of organic esters. Suppose C2H5ON, this is a nitrite, then ethyl nitrite. These are the IUPAC names of the nitrite. Nitroalkanes and alkyl nitrites are functional isomers of each other. Nitroalkanes, in that primary nitroalkanes, secondary nitroalkanes and tertiary nitroalkanes with their examples. Now next homologous series, nomenclature of nitriles or cyanides. They contain cyano group represented as RCN. R may be alkyl or aryl group. Functional group is CN and suffix is nitrile. Now R, consider some examples that are methyl and then join CN, that is methyl cyanide, then ethyl, this CN, then this R isopropyl group to which CN, this is vinyl group to which CN. These are the some examples of cyanides. Now consider the first member here hydrogen to which cyanide is attached. Actually this is a hydrocyanic acid. I have taken here only for nomenclature purpose. Okay, consider the common names. Actually cyanides are the derivatives of carboxylic acid. And you know that you studied in previous session aldehyde, carboxylic acid and all derivatives of carboxylic acids. In that, the first member named as a form, that is one carbon, first member is a form. Then word for two carbon, that is second member, acid. Actually, these words are originated from the sources of origin. Three carbon, that is third member, propion. You studied this part. Four, butyl. Isobutyl, 4 carbon, isobutyl, then this is, consider this, later on, actually this is acrylo group, that is acryl, okay, and now this is first carbon form, notice remain, nitrile is remain, therefore, join the nitrile before that O is added. Therefore, O nitrile, formonitrile. Then add O nitrile, that is acetonitrile. O nitrile. Then butyl O nitrile, butyronitrile. Isobutyronitrile. Acrylonitrile. These are the common names of this compound. Now one more system is there to write the name of the cyanides is the cyanide system. In that, cyanide word is used. Now this is a cyanide. What is remain? Hydrogen. Therefore name is hydrogen cyanide. Is a hydrogen cyanide. Next, this is cyanide and remainder is methyl cyanide. This methyl cyanide. Next alkyl group present is ethyl. Ethyl cyanide. Therefore, name is ethyl cyanide. N-propyl cyanide. N-propyl cyanide. Next member is isopropyl cyanide. Write the name of the alkyl group and then cyanide. Therefore, in cyanide system, the name is like this, alkyl cyanide. Alkyl cyanide. Write the name of the alkyl group and then join cyanide. And in one more system, this one, write a specific word and then join O-nitrile, because these are derivatives of carboxylic acids. Okay. Next, now consider their IUPAC name. Here, the one more cyanide system, the name is vinyl cyanide. It is vinyl group, vinyl cyanide. Now consider their IUPAC name. As usual, one carbon, therefore methane, and the suffix is nitrile, therefore methane nitrile. Not necessary to drop or delete this E because it starts with N. Then total two carbon, therefore ethane nitrile. It is very simple. Count the number of carbon atom and then join the suffix. Number of carbon atom, write the base name, propane nitrile. Then four carbon atoms, therefore butane nitrile. Now next here continuous three carbon atoms, start numbering from this, therefore propane. Now this is a substituent present on 2, therefore prefix is 2-methyl propane nitrile. 2-methyl propane nitrile. Now the IUPAC name of this compound, start numbering from this, therefore prop 2 in nitrile. Prop 2 in nitrile. Actually here the double bond is only possible on this carbon, this and this, that is in between this. Therefore it is not necessary to mention these two. You may write propene nitrile. That is, the in general, the IUPAC name is alkane nitrile. Number of carbon atoms, word root is alkane, join the suffix nitrile. Here, I already told you that in the IUPAC name, suffix is used, and in the common name, is family name is nitrile or the cyanide, these words are used. Now let us consider last family nomenclature of isonitriles, also called as isocyanides or carbyl amines. Actually, you studied cyanides. In this group, there are two centers of joining. If it is joined through carbon, called as cyanides, and if it is joined through this nitrogen, it is called as isocyanide. Both are functional isomers of one another. Now consider the nomenclature of isocyanides. Representation is R and C. R may be alkyl or aryl group. Functional group is NC and prefix is isocyano. Now the common names are methyl isocyanide or also called as methyl isonitriles, or they may be referred as methyl carbylamine. Then next member, ethyl isocyanide or ethyl isonitrile or ethyl carbylamine. And the IUPAC name, this NC group is considered as a prefix. Therefore, this is a prefix. And then this alkane, that is isocyanomethane. Right, first prefix, isocyanomethane. Here two carbon atoms, therefore isocyanoethane. Isocyanoethane. Consider here, you studied now the compound containing nitrogen in that primary, secondary, tertiary amines, then primary, secondary, tertiary nitroalkanes, then nitrides, then cyanides, then isocyanides. One more compound here, aromatic diazo compounds, you have to consider that later on in aromatic session. But here, diazomethane. This is diazomethane. And in compound containing nitrogen, nitroalkanes are there. The substituted nitroalkane, this is common name is chloropicrin. And IUPAC name, one carbon, therefore trichloronitromethane. Trichloronitromethane. Now, let us see the references for this nomenclature.